So, today we're going to be evaluating polynomial functions. So, what is a polynomial function? I'm going to use this equation and show you exactly what makes up a polynomial function. So, when you have a polynomial function, when your exponents of your variables, and remember, x is the same thing as x to the 1 power, it's always good to write that out, when all your exponents of your variables are whole numbers. So, you couldn't have something that looked like 4x to the negative 2. You couldn't have something that looked like 4x to the radical 2. You couldn't have 4x to 2.5. And you couldn't have something that looked like 4x to the x power, because none of these are whole number exponents. So you will never see that in a polynomial function. All right, so now we're going to learn some vocabulary about polynomial functions. A constant in a polynomial function is the number without a variable next to it. So in this case, it's going to be negative 6 because it doesn't have a variable next to it. A degree of a polynomial function. Whenever you're looking for degree, you always want to make sure you look at the exponents. Remember, x is the same thing as x to the 1 power. You always want to look at the exponents to find the degree. And your degree is going to be your highest exponent. In this case, it's going to be 2. Okay? Now, a leading coefficient in a polynomial function is the number in front of a variable with the biggest exponent. In this case, it's going to be 4. Because 2 is your biggest exponent that you have. Because remember, x is the same thing as x to the 1 power. So, and 2 is bigger than 1, and 4 is in front of x squared. So that is your leading coefficient, because it's the number in front of the variable with the biggest exponent. Now we're going to learn how to write polynomial equations in standard form. To put it in standard form, and I'm just going to do this real quick, remember, it's the same thing, 4x is the same thing as 4x to the 1 power. To write it in standard form, you got to make sure that all your exponents are in descending order, from left to right, all the way to your constant. And if you don't have a constant, just make sure that your exponents are in descending order from left to right. So let's write this in standard form. So it's going to be 4x to the 4th plus 4x to the 1, I'm just writing it so you see all the exponents, minus 6. That is now your correct standard form. All right? So now we're going to be learning how to name certain types of polynomial functions. You name polynomial functions based off their degree. And to call it a linear function, its degree has to be 1. As you can see, your highest exponent in all these equations are 1. So they're all linear functions because all their degrees are 1. In a quadratic function, it's basically the same thing, except your degree is now 2. And as you can see in all these equations, your highest exponent is 2. So they're all quadratic functions. In a cubic function, your degree is always going to be 3. And as you can see, your highest exponent in any of these equations are 3. So they're all cubic functions. In a quartic function, your degree is always going to be 4. As you can see in all these equations, your highest exponent is 4. So they're all quartic functions. So to review again, make sure when you're naming polynomial functions, you always look at the highest or your degree that you have in order to name it. So again, a linear, your degree is always going to be 1. A quadratic, your degree is always going to be 2. And a cubic function, your degree is always going to be 3. And in a quartic function, your degree is always going to be 4. Okay? So I hope the video helped. Good luck with your homework, guys. Thanks for watching.